Chinese President Xi Jinping has tasked the city's new chief executive, Carrie Lam, with the difficult job of healing Hong Kong's divide. Both believe education is a key way of achieving that goal. Many of Hong Kong's younger citizens, born around and just before the handover, have played a key role in protest movements during the past few years, and Beijing appears to believe that it can use education to snuff out dissent.
Any attempt to endanger China's sovereignty and security, challenge the power of the central government, is an act that crosses the red line and is absolutely impermissible.
Despite Xi's warnings, tens of thousands took to the streets of Hong Kong Saturday, vowing not to be silent and voicing their concerns about a range of issues. Past efforts to promote patriotic education have not only failed but fueled anger toward the Hong Kong government and mistrust of China. It was clear from Saturday's protests that for some, that sentiment hasn't changed.
They are not thinking about us when they talk about changing education. They just want people to give the Chinese government more.
Sharoni Huang feels less threatened when it comes to Beijing's intentions and education. Her son Luffy is a primary school student. She was a teenager when the handover took place.
We have already been breathing this air of freedom for a long time. We can choose those things from Chinese history that are worth keeping, and those other things we can just ignore. We are not stupid, we're well educated, right?
Huang likes that her son is getting more Chinese lessons at school.
Is it really all just about them changing us? Hong Kong may be small, but its population of 7 million is no small force.
Arthur Au, a former accountant turned vegetarian restaurant owner, was a young boy when Hong Kong was returned to China. He says what he is looking for from the new administration are clear objectives and goals. When it comes to education, he thinks students should be exposed to different ways of thinking.
The government may be trying to do some homework to please China, to bring these materials to Hong Kong education system. Yeah, I don't reject this, but it depends on how they present the whole thing.
Hong Kong's new leader has pledged to pump $700 million more into the education system each year and to teach children from kindergarten that they are Chinese. How she handles the contentious policy could be one of her biggest early challenges, and depending on how it's handled, could widen instead of heal a growing divide. Bill Ide, VOA News, Hong Kong.